What if I told you that everything you know about energy is about to change? Imagine never having to stop for gas again. Never having to charge your car. Never having to worry about fuel prices. Sounds impossible, right? That's exactly what they said about the Wright brothers, about Tesla, about every breakthrough that changed the world. On February 10th, 2025, something happened in Zimbabwe that made the impossible possible. Zimbabwean innovator Maxwell Chikumbutso finally launched his vehicle on the 10th of February 2025. Now, though I made a video about this last week, many people came into the comment section and were like, very skeptical. Some people say that this technology doesn't really make sense and they are not really sure that it's going to come live. But then Chikumbutso had already made a launch date on the 10th, and that day seems to be judgment day, that everybody is actually waiting for it. Finally, we have come to the D-Day.
They've just given us, we saw a very interesting technological thing that you have been offering here, but many people are still in doubt. What is the source and how reliable is this, and is this going to be able to sustain for years?
But I think you've seen, like, the guys who came from Israel, we've got guys who came from Switzerland. These are the guys I've been working with for years. They have tested it. Some of them, they've bought my products before, like Emmanuel, I think he bought two machines for himself. Right now he bought a car. Right now he bought a motorbike, which he's taking with him. So it's all about the proof of the pudding. He tested it. That's why he came. Operation. And whoever who wants a machine can now get it. We've got our distributor here in Zimbabwe who is going to be handling all the sales in Zimbabwe.
The streets of Harare erupted with celebration. Social media exploded with the launch of this marvelous car. In reality, Chikumbutso wasn't launching a car. He was launching a technology that could be put into any car in the world.
All the cars that you know, if you go to Kaya right now, all their cars, you have to plug in either a DC charging station or an AC charging station. Our car is the first car. This is a generator. I think if you can go to the fridge, you can see it's going to plug in, and you will see that the fridge is going to be powered by a car. Like I said, you can buy a car. You don't need to have a generator at your home. You use your car.
That's the car.
So where is the microsonic device?
What we have done, like we said, the microsonic energy device is the invention that we have done, and we are trying to protect it. We have embedded it in the vehicle.
Okay.
Yes. And it has got a self-destructive technology. On the 150 wires on this car, if you try to tamper with five of them, which we classify, you destroy the microsonic energy device, both on the software and the hardware. Wow. That's how we are protecting the technology, because we couldn't get a patent.
Oh. So more like it.
Yes, it's encrypted. It's on. It's on right now.
It's on.
Oh, yeah. So there are no mechanical, there are no like moving parts.
The only moving part that you will see on this car is a reduction gearbox. But you don't have to maintain it to service it.
The generator doesn't have.
The generator doesn't have any moving parts. Usually those type of devices are known as zero point energy. So you cannot even maintain it, you cannot service it, because there is no friction that is happening.
Wow.
We've been working on ways on how to protect the technology in the event that we lose it. For example, we go in a country, we set up a power station, there's a hostile takeover, we're kicked. How do you protect our technology? That's why we took the trade secret route. Our patent is kept, our design is kept, the recipe is kept in three countries, and the people who are keeping it, they don't even know each other.
The second thing, we tried to protect the hardware side, because if an engineer removed like a second board, you can trace, you can see that this is a rectifier, this is a microchip. So we put a small amount of a detonator to say, but that cannot harm anyone. But if you just try to tamper with it, you blow it. That's part of the second board. Also on the software, if someone can have the source code, he can try to do reverse engineering. So we work on an algorithm that if you tamper with certain wires on the vehicle, you are going to destroy the microsonic energy device.
So you're
going to
tamper with it?
Yeah.
So you can't tamper?
You cannot tamper with it. If you tamper with it, then you lose your investment.
Question, what would be the market price for it?
So what? Which products do you have on the market?
The car?
Are the batteries on the market?
The greener power grid machines are on the market. The TVs are on the market. The bikes are on the market. The cars as well, they are on the market.
When people say your microsonic technology can't be proven, what do you say to that?
You know, thank you very much, because we yet not find ways of protecting the IP, like I said. As you know, in science we say, prove it. It's not about arguments, prove it. So we drive our car to Cairo, live on TV, everyone watching. That would be enough for it. And right now we're doing this because we are now on the commercial level. So I understand what you're saying very well. And also the other thing, my brother, that I want to tell you.
He explains that the energy used in his innovation is called microsonic energy. Now this energy is found in the air, just like many other energies like radiation energy. But then the energy is very minimal. With current technologies, energy from this sphere, from radio waves, can be extracted and used. But it is going to be very minimal and not really economically feasible to produce in large scale. But Chikumbutso has found a way to amplify the radio waves and use it in large scale. This is not the first time that Chikumbutso is using radio energy to power devices. He had done this several years ago, powering a TV set.
This is our self-powered TV that we have designed. The first in the world to have such kind of a technology where a television is powered with a radio frequency. So as you can see right now, I'm powering this television. So this is the first television in the world that uses self-power, to say. It is all in one. You don't need to put it on electricity or on solar panel or anything, as it is a complete solution. Behind the television, you can see that there is a microsonic energy device, this box. This is the device that is converting radio frequencies into pure energy. As you can see, the power of the cable was supposed to be here. On all traditional televisions, power comes here, but there's no power, as you can see. The television is working as it is. So in layman, I think this television is we can call it a self-powered television.
The streets of Harare, Zimbabwe's capital, erupted with celebrations, and social media exploded with reactions. The energy companies went quiet. Now I can already hear some of you typing, but is this not made in China? Well, let me ask you something. Where is your iPhone made? Where does Tesla build many of its cars? Even Apple and Tesla, two of the most innovative American companies, they manufacture in China. You see, Chikumbutso isn't just building one car. He's created something much more bigger, an energy system that could power any vehicle around the world. And he is ready to partner with major auto manufacturers to transform the entire industry. Think about that for a moment. Every car on the road, powered by infinite clean energy. Now I know what you're thinking, this has to be fake, right? Yes, that's what some experts said before, until they witnessed this with their own eyes. Now let me explain to you how this works. Here's where it gets fascinating. You know how your radio picks up music from thin air? Those are radio frequencies. invisible waves traveling all around us. Chikumbutso figured out how to turn these waves into pure energy. Think of it like a radio that plays power instead of music. Now, generally, the systems to extract energy from this method already exist in this world, but they are economically not feasible and are very minute that can hardly power any device. But Chikumbutso has figured out a way to amplify this energy and make it economically available, meaning that a car like this has no range. It means it can go as far as it can until you have a tire puncture or you have a mechanical problem. In our last video, we said that scientists never understood how this was possible, and that's the reason why his technology was not given a patent. So what happens next when energy becomes as free as air? Who loses power? Who gains it? And why are some of the world's biggest companies suddenly very, very nervous? Now, this story isn't over yet. In fact, it is just the beginning. And I want to know, what would you do if you have access to unlimited energy? And if you want to know how innovations like this are reshaping our world, hit the like button and see you in my next video. Ciao.